I once knew a woman who couldn't spell it, and her face was as strange as a smile. The clothes what she wore was a terrible fit from the year behind yesterday's style. All she ever said was hello and goodbye, and then she'd sit dumb for an hour. And sometimes to sing a sweet song she would try, but himmel, it came out so sour. Yet any time up to her house you could go, it was always packed up like a good nickel show. For, oh, how that woman could cook, her food was like grand opera sound. Why, you could give her dining room table one look, right away you gain 7 pounds. A sick man could eat himself well pretty quick, and when he got well, well, he ate himself sick, and her pies, without question, would cure indisception. Oh, God, how that woman could cook. When she gave a party, and then a big spread, she hired a hall like a dance. And all those who knew of it, 1 week ahead, stopped eating 2 weeks in advance. The singing and playing of games were all nicked. Who cared for post office or bits? For the 12 o'clock lunch, they were ready at 6, and no old maid wished to be kissed. The way they would rush, for the table's a crime. I know, because I was there first all the time. For, oh, how that woman could cook, the blue points and cocktails were out. She didn't care for the White House cookbook, and we started with spare ribs and trout. When someone stopped eating, her feelings were hurt, and we always had hot water bags for dessert. With our hearts wildly beating, we cried, let's die eating. Ah, oh, God, how that woman could cook. I once had a meal in a high-toned hotel where the waiters were dressed up like dudes. The crockery and the silver were terribly swell, but I didn't care much for the food. So I ordered some consomme account of the name. I thought I'd be swell when in doubt. But it made me quite crazy to find when it came, it was the soup with the filling left out. So I said, here, my waiter, come out here. Here's a tip. When you're hungry, to my friend's house, just take a trip. Or, oh, how that woman could bake. I tell you, the words won't come out. Why, she made a pie called plum pudding cake. It simply would melt in your mouth. No doubt her sauces and pudding would just make you weep. And when you drank her coffee, your feet fell asleep. And her liver and onions would cure corns and bunions. Gott in Himmel, how that woman could cook.